Do you want to share your files quickly and easily? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know when it comes to sharing your files and folders right here within Google Drive. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And the first thing you need to know when it comes to sharing your files or your folders is how to open up the share dialog. Now, when you have opened up any Google file, up in the top right-hand corner, you will see a share button. Here within this Google Sheet, you can see I have this green share button, and by selecting this, I will open up the share dialog. However, this isn't the only place that we can access that share button. Even if you have other files which are not Google specific, so for example, here I have an image, I will still have access to that share option. If I select the More Actions, I can come down here and select Share as well. But perhaps the easiest way to share your files is from the main menu, because perhaps you don't want to jump in and out of all of your files, or perhaps you'd like to share multiple files at once. So by selecting any file, you will also have the share option here in the top right-hand corner. We can also right-click on a file, and about the third option down is the share option, but maybe the fastest of all is if you select any file or folder and then select the period key on your keyboard, that will also prompt up the share dialog. Now, our very first step is to select the people or email addresses in which we would like to share this file with. Remember, all of your contacts within Google Contacts will appear here, but they don't have to. You can enter in any new email addresses as well. And if you happen to have groups within Google Contacts, those will also be available to you here as well. So I'm going to enter in this dummy account and add this individual because I would like to share this document with them. Next, I want to take a look at the drop-down menu directly to the right of the name or names that I've input here. Now, by default, it's going to select them as an editor, but that may not be the right selection for you. As an editor, in this case, they will be able to add and edit anything within this Google Sheet. But we do have two other options available to us as well. The first one is as a viewer. This will give them read-only access so that they can see the entire sheet, but they won't be able to make any changes. The second one down below is of a commenter, which is kind of like a viewer, but they also have the ability to add suggestions. This won't make any changes to your file or to your document, but you will be able to see any suggestions or any comments which they add. So make sure that you decide what is the most appropriate level that you would like to grant to this user or users. Now, down below, we have a checkbox, which will be selected by default, telling us that this will notify these individuals once we hit the send button. With this checkbox selected, we can enter in a message, such as, just wanted to share the new file with you. If you do not want a notification sent out directly from Google Drive, you can uncheck this checkbox. In this case, you have two options available to you. By selecting the blue share button down below, they will instantly have access to this file within their Google Drive account. Or if you would like to send them the link via email or some other form of messaging, you can select copy link. And now I have a link copied to my clipboard and I can paste that into my message, an SMS, or some other messaging format. Now, before we hit share in this case, I want to pay special attention to one more option available to us, and that is the settings or gear icon in the top right-hand corner. By selecting this option here, we have two additional checkboxes available to us. The first one says editors can change permissions and share. With this checkbox selected, anyone who I select or add as an editor here will also be able to share it with other people and change permissions. If I do not want to give them that level of permission, I can uncheck this checkbox. The second option down below says viewers and commenters can see the option to download, print, and copy. Keep in mind that this second checkbox does not apply to editors. Editors will certainly have the ability to download, print, and copy. But maybe I just want to give someone a preview of this file. So I'm going to make them a viewer. If I also want to make sure that they can't make a copy for themselves or they cannot download that file, I would leave this checkbox unchecked as well. So depending on the file that you're sharing, make sure that you select that gear icon and double check just before you hit share. Now that I'm ready to share, I'm going to select share. And now you can see that we have a new share icon beside this file type. Just like we looked down below, I have a few other files that have that share icon as well. So even at a glance, I can see whom I'm sharing these files or folders with. Now, what if we want to share with additional people the same file, or perhaps we want to remove access? Well, we can hit that share button in the variety of ways or use our shortcut key of the period key on our keyboard. And now we will always have full access as to whom we have shared these files with. So here is the individual that I've made as a viewer, but perhaps I want them to get more involved with this file. I can simply come down to the right side and change their ability from viewer to an editor in this case. Of course, they won't become an editor until I hit this save button down below. The other thing that we want to pay attention to here is that perhaps I want to remove access to this individual as well. Well, I can do so here by this dropdown and remove access so that they no longer can access this file. The one above here you can see is transfer ownership, but it's currently disabled because I don't have anyone as an editor at the moment. If I save this and make that individual an editor and then reopen this file, I can now come down and transfer ownership to them. In this case, they will have all the abilities that I currently have, and they will be the owner going forward. I will still have access to this file, but they will be the owner of this particular file. Down below, you will also notice that we have another option available to us as soon as we have shared this file with one or more individuals. And this is giving us the ability to restrict, meaning that this file will only be shared with people who can open the link, but we can choose to change that to anyone with the link. Now, this might be helpful if you're wanting to share something with the world or something publicly, such as perhaps a lead magnet or some other free resource, and you don't want to have to add individuals one by one, and it's not sensitive information. In this case, I can choose anyone with the link, and then I can select copy that link. And now when I go and paste it, let me open up an incognito window just to show you, they will have direct access to this sheet. Now keep in mind, they only have view only access, so they can't make any changes to the sheet. I'm trying to hit delete on my keyboard. I'm trying to enter in other numbers. I can't do so because I only have view only access. So another safe and easy way to share files with others, in this case, if you want to publicly share that file with the rest of the world. Now, don't forget, all of these share options and settings which we've reviewed also apply to folders within Google Drive. Let me take a quick look at this test folder. I have 5 different folders within this folder and a variety of different files as well. But perhaps going forward, I don't want to have to manage one by one or file by file who has access. Maybe I have colleagues that I want to give access to everything within this folder. folder, either now or when files are added to any of these folders. In this case, all I need to do is select the folder I want to share, hit the drop-down menu, and then select Share. And we are going to be prompted with the exact same menu that we saw when it came to sharing files. In this case, I'm going to add another individual here. I'm going to make them an editor in this particular case. I'm going to hit send, and once again, we will see that that share icon is visible here. And now, going forward, any new files that I add within these folders will be shared with everyone else who has shared access. So a quick and easy way to share multiple files, multiple folders, both in the present and going forward. Now, to get even easier access to all of your Drive files and folders, be sure to use Drive for Desktop. To learn how to set up for yourself on your computer, be sure to watch this video next. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.